بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأفضل الصلوات وأتم التسليمات على النبي رحمة للعالمين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي، أما بعد. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا. All praises and gratitude are due to Almighty Allah Azza wa Jal, the Creator, Nourisher and Cherisher of this universe. Peace, blessings and salutations upon our beloved master and leader, Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, amma ba'd. Often we are faced with a question and a dilemma. We tend to ask ourselves, we tend to ask people, we sometimes approach our scholars, we have this discussion in our social gatherings and settings as to the current situation around us and the problems that we experience and we see. And it varies, they are vast from different types, whether it is on a micro level or on a macro level. On a macro level, if you look at within the countries, the borders of the countries we live in, there's always discussion around the crisis of crime that is rising, the gangs that are rising and increasing. Similarly, the loss of life that is taking place. We look around us internationally, globally, and we find that there is continuous turmoil, and there is a sense of, you know, when you just open the media nowadays, it is enough to give us some degree of stress and to put a person into some degree of depression. So we are faced with this dilemma, we are faced with this question, that what is the solution? What could we do that could change and could be, we at least intransitively and within ourselves, for ourselves, we could feel better as human beings, as ourselves. So this is this kind of dilemma that we are faced with, and it's natural and it's very valid given what we see around us today. So let us go back to the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we always look for guidance by Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The hadith I want to share with you is from Abu Dawood and Tirmidhi. It is classified as a hadith sahih. Narrator of the hadith is Irbad ibn Sariyah radiyallahu an, Abu Najih. He says that once Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam he gave us a khutbah and a sermon, some advices. And it was of such a nature, كَأَنَّهَا وَجِلَتْ مِنْهَا الْقُلُوبُ وَذَرَفَتْ مِنْهَا الْعُيُونَ. The hearts were taken aback, trembling, really felt, softened and pain. You know, sometimes we sit in a lecture, in a talk, many scholar, or we listen to it online sometimes. We're really taken by it, you know, we're really taken by it. So the heart is softened. وَجِلَتْ مِنْهَا الْقُلُوبُ ذَرَفَتْ مِنْهَا الْعُيُونَ. وَذَرِفَتْ مِنْهَا الْعُيُونَ. The eyes were flowing with tears. Eyes were flowing with tears. So Sahaba radiallahu anhum, human like we are, they asked Ya Rasulullah, كَأَنَّهَا مُعِذَةُ مُوَدِّعِ. This advice of yours, Ya Rasulullah, this khutbah of yours, it is as if it is the khutbah or the speech of a person who is going to pass. In muwaddi', you know, when you are about to say farewell and bid your farewells and pay your final respects and pay your final salams, it's a very somber moment. It's a very it's at that moment where a person is kind of serious and sincere and shares that which is, you know, from the depth of the heart. Subhanallah. So Ya Rasulullah, if this be that case, what would you advise us as a parting advice? Look at subhanAllah, look at the wisdom and look at the foresight of Sahaba. Ya Rasulullah, what would be your parting advice? Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّهُ مَنْ يَعِشْ مِنْكُمْ that أُصِيكُمْ بِتَقْوَى اللَّهِ. The very first thing I will enjoin you, my Sahaba, is have the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our heart. We have previously talked of this here, and you have often and over and multiple times have heard this word in the Quran, in the hadith, from your scholars, and which is at the head of everything, and that is the you know, we will say it in inverted commas, the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yani the fear of transgressing the laws of Allah, which will then obviously draw the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the consciousness of our Creator in every step of our life's journey, whatever we do. Am I doing something which pleases my Lord, or am I doing something which displeases my Lord? That is the taqwa of Allah in a nutshell. Al-khawf min al-jaleel, to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-qana'atu bil-qaleel, to be content with a little. Al-isti'adad li-yawm al-raheel, to prepare. Wal-amal bil-tanzeel, to practice on the teachings of Quran and Hadith. And to prepare, isti'adad li-yawm al-raheel, prepare for our journey, our final journey. So that's the taqwa of Allah. Subhanallah, Rasulullah SAW said, number one is the taqwa of Allah. Was-sam'i wa-ta'a. Was-sam'i wa-ta'a. Listen and obey. This is the hallmark of a believer. We are not one to create rebellion. We are not one to rebel. We are not one to cause controversy and to cause mayhem and mischief and discord and disunity. Sam'a wa-ta'a. A believer is listen and obey. Subhanallah. And then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam further goes and elaborates and says, وَإِن تَأَمَّرَ عَلَيْكُمْ عَبْدٌ. Even if a slave, who, you know, we cannot understand, really understand and perceive the value of a slave. But even if a slave happens to, you know, assume the position or the pulpit of power, in that case too, do not rebel, listen and obey. Each person will have his or her day. Subhanallah. So sam'a wa ta'a, this is a very vast field and discussion. We unfortunately did not have the time to cover it and talk of this in detail. And it's important to refer to our scholars and don't take anything just on immediate face value. Refer to our scholars again, inshallah, so that we can get the true understanding of this part of the hadith. Sam'a wa ta'a. And then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, and this is our main problem. فَإِنَّهُ مَنْ يَعِشْ مِنْكُمْ فَسَيْرَ اِخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا. Verily, the person who will be blessed with life, you know, and live to see some years, you will see a lot of ikhtilaf. You will see a lot of problems. You will see a lot of differences. You will see a lot of issues. Okay, this is what we are currently seeing, and it's going to get worse as we progress towards al-qiyamah, the final day. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, now what should you be doing? And that's why I said, we can try, and we might not be able to make a change on a global scale. Subhanallah. The keys to the treasures are in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So who is designed for that? That is not in our knowledge. But at least each and every human being and every individual can strive to make a change within themselves and their households. So he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, فَعَلَيْكُمْ بِسُنَّتِي وَسُنَّةِ الْخُلَفَاءِ الرَّاشِدِينَ الْمَهْدِيِّينَ. You should hold on firmly, عَلَيْكُمْ, hold on firmly to my sunnah, the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the ways of the rightly guided khulafa, subhanallah. Addu alayha bin nawajiz. One is he used the word alaykum, which means hold on very firmly, like wajib. And then he says, addu alayha bin nawajiz. Bite onto it with your molars. That is how strongly you should be rooted, and deeply you should be and firmly holding on to the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That do not waver from that position. Whatever we do in life, do it according to how the Prophet ﷺ did it. It was the successful formula 1400 years ago. It is the successful formula today, and it will be the successful formula before the Qiyamah comes as well. Subhanallah. So remember this year, our guide in life in every matter of our existence is Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, وَإِيَّاكُمَ مُحْدَثَاتِ الْأُمُورِ, and beware of innovating any matters in your deen, subhanallah. Again, stick firmly to the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Everything. So inshallah, if we can do that, then we will be in good times. فَإِنَّ كُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ. Every innovation is a form of misguidance and will take you further away from the righteous path of the sunnah instead of bringing you closer to the sunnah. So in a nutshell, my dearest friends, brothers and sisters in Islam, you know, whilst we may experience a sense of stress and depression and difficulty and confusion, we can try and at least bring change in our own lives, and that is by coming onto the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam diligently and very religiously, inshallah, and this will, we will see a lot of khair and a lot of barakah, inshallah, moving forward in our days ahead. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us tawfiq of understanding. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, subhanaka allahumma wa bihamdika, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk, wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.